A moment of meditation, joy of Zion Church. Let's confess together. I am a spirit. I have a soul. I live in a body. I am a new creation. God loves me. God blesses me. God makes me righteous. God gives me peace that the world cannot give. I am grateful. I am thankful. I am delighted. I am happy, I am joyful, I am okay, I am doing good. In Christ, I am a person with overwhelming confidence to win in any situation and circumstance. I am a victor, not a victim. In Christ, I am a person who has the ability to control my inner climate regardless of external circumstances. I am a spirit having the spirit. In Christ, I'm a person who has the ability to maintain a positive attitude in a negative situation. I am blessed to be a blessing. I will never, never, never be the same again. Your life is shaped by your thoughts. Keep thy heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. Proverbs chapter 4, verse 23. It's not every thought that comes to you that is from God. The only way you know the source of your thoughts is through the light of God's Word and the ministry of the Holy Spirit. It's very important what you think about and how you think, because your life is shaped by your thoughts. Our theme verse in the Good News Translation says, "Be careful how you think. Your life is shaped by your thoughts." Screen and filter your thoughts. Mount Gerizim over your heart, because out of your heart are the issues of life. You have to be the policeman of your heart. Take charge of your heart. Don't allow every thought. Allow only God's thought, righteous thoughts, and thoughts of love in Christ Jesus. The Bible specifically lets us know the kind of thoughts to allow. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of a good report, if there be any virtue, and if there be any praise, think on these things. Philippians chapter 4, verse 8. You are the character of your thoughts. What you think about, you become. The Lord Jesus actually related this in his teachings in a most enlightening way. He said, "Ye have heard that it was said by them of old time, Thou shalt not commit adultery. But I say unto you, that whosoever looketh on a woman to lust after her hath committed adultery with her already in his heart." Matthew chapter 5, verses 27 to 28. Your thoughts can deliver to you a glorious life or keep you on the sidewalk of life. If you do let the word dominate your thinking, it will create the right thoughts in you and give you the right mindset. You do think victory, success, dominion, and possibilities only. Romans chapter 12, verse 2 says, "And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind." When your thoughts are consistent with the word, your life will be a reflection of its glory. For the glory is in the world. So discipline your mind to accept only the right thoughts. Prayer. Dear Father, I consciously think the right thoughts and meditate only on things that are true, honest, just, pure, lovely, of a good report, virtuous, and praiseworthy. Therefore, I fulfill all your plans for me. By your word, I make my way prosperous and walk in absolute victory. In Jesus' name, amen. I hope so much Jesus be inside you and covers you today. Have a glorious day or have a glorious night. See you tomorrow.